5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। विद रेगार्ड टू द सुगर केन ड्यूज ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्रॉसिंग सीजन, इट इज सॉट टू बी कंटेंडेड दैट एट द टाइम ऑफ अलॉटमेंट ऑफ केन परचेज सेंटर्स इन क्वेश्चन बाय द केन कमिश्नर ऑन 20 नवंबर 2016, मेनी अदर सुगर मिल्स वर आल्सो इन डिफॉल्ट ऑफ द पेमेंट ऑफ एरियर्स ऑफ प्रीवियस क्रॉसिंग सीजन एंड देवर आइदर अलॉटेड मोर क्वांटिटी ऑफ सुगर केन एंड दियर एरियाज वर नॉट कर्टेल्ड द एरियर्स ऑफ केन ड्यूज ऑफ द सिक्स रेस्पोंडेंट फॉर क्रॉसिंग सीजन 2015-16 cannot be made the sole determinative factor in the assignment of cane purchase centers. Each and every guided factor under Rule 22 of Rules of 1954 is equally important in the matter of reservation and assignment of area. The entire dues for the current crushing season 2016-17 are being duly and timely paid by the sixth respondent against the total dues of rupees 110 lakhs and rupees 91 lakhs have been paid for the present crushing season 2016-17 and the position of cane price payment as on 17 January 2017 for the current season 2016-17 has been brought on record as annexure CA4. So far as the dues for the previous crushing season 2015-16 are concerned, it is submitted that the sixth respondent is making all efforts to clear its debts of the previous crushing season and the sixth respondent is required sufficient sugar cane for its survival, revival and for clearing its past dues. It is submitted that the cane commissioner has to strike the balance between the sugar mills for which he can give weightage to one factor over other, keeping in view the prevailing circumstances in the interest of sugar factory as well as sugar cane growers, but it does not mean that he is permitted to overlook the other factor. Rather, it can be said that he has to look into the matter of one sugar mill in comparison to other sugar mill, considering all the guided factors and apply the same in the prevailing circumstances. Accordingly, the appellate authority considered the distance of the disputed cane centers from the petitioner and the sixth respondent. The distance of the cane purchase centers in question in much closer to the mill of sixth respondent in comparison to the petitioner sugar mill, and the appellate authority has rightly considered the same while allotting the cane centers in dispute to the sixth respondent. The appellate authority has also considered the fact that the cane centers in question were reserved centers of the sixth respondent and the same was continuously allotted to the sixth respondent in the previous years. The sixth respondent had paid the entire dues towards sugar cane price and commission for all years except the last crushing season for the regions beyond its control. The sixth respondent was constrained to approach the Board of Industrial and Financial Reconstruction in the year 2015. The sixth respondent is before the BIFR and is undergoing restructuring. However, the sixth respondent was restrained by the BIFR from alienating or transferring or otherwise creating any third party right interest in respect of their immovable assets without permission of the BIFR. Against the order dated 6 June 2016, the six respondent had preferred an appeal before the appellate authority for industrial and financial reconstruction. The AAIFR set aside the order dated 6 June 2016 and permitted the six respondent from selling its assets. In terms of the said order, the sixth respondent had clearly mentioned the assets to be sold and suggested a scheme relating to the entire sale proceeds from the sale of its assets, which were to be deposited for payment of arrears of cane dues for crushing season 2015-16. AAIFR directed that the entire sale proceeds from the sale of assets would be deposited in a joint account to be operated by the nominee of the district cane officer and the nominee of the sixth respondent. The sale proceeds would be used solely for payment of the dues of the cane growers. The sixth respondent already entered into an agreement to sell the part of the property area 4.9 hectare for a sum of rupees 14 crores, but due to the demonetization, the sale of the property has been delayed.